things are going to start happening very quickly now with Wolverine 3. Like, for instance, it's now called Logan. And that's because the movie's actually coming out pretty darn soon, March 3rd, 2017, as you can see. And also Wolverine says, Hugh Jackman, he is kind of known as Wolverine, and we'll see if maybe he can change that now that this is his final film. But I think he's one of those actors that's very grateful for what the character has done for his career, and we'll talk about that in this video. But Hugh Jackman has said that James Mangold is working very hard in cutting the movie. They're getting close to the final cut, and therefore they're ready to advertise. And that, he has said, includes a trailer or a teaser, you know, in the next few days, like in the next week or so. So things are going to be, coming into focus very quickly with this film. They've kept a pretty good lid on it, actually. I mean, we know a little bit about it. And what we're going to discuss is what we know right now in this moment of time, updated with this poster before the trailer hits. All right, so these are the new things that we know thanks to the poster. And then we'll talk about what we already knew, just to recap. So, the title, it's Logan, right? And I think that's an obvious nod to Old Man Logan. Ever since they said that Wolverine would be older in this movie, and Hugh Jackman has joked that makes it easier for him to play the character. Although I think Hugh Jackman is too hard on himself. I think he's aged really well, and he looks fantastic. I've never been like, it's getting time for you to leave, Hugh Jackman. I think he has more than one Wolverine movie left in him. But anyway, I respect his decision. But Logan, I guess he doesn't want to be, his agent's like, don't go with Old Man Logan. Just call it Logan and everyone will know what you're referring to. So although I'd be curious for non-fans, you know, if they're like, Logan, unless you're really familiar with that famous Wolverine story, you're not like, oh yeah, I can't wait to see Logan this weekend. Ooh. I have some theories on that as well, though. Then the second thing I think that this poster does is pretty much confirm X-23 with that kid's hand. It's X-23 is the junior version of Wolverine. It's a clone of him, and it's a girl. Now, in the comics, it's a sexy girl. It's basically the idea of, what if Wolverine had boobs? Would he be even more popular? And the answer is no, he wouldn't, because X-23 isn't as popular as Wolverine. I've liked her when she stepped forward, now that Wolverine is currently deceased in the comic books in the 616. They brought the older version of him from the Old Man Logan version, actually, from an alternate timeline. But still, the official Wolverine in the Marvel Comics universe right now, the 616, is X-23, Laura Kinney. But here you can see she's much younger, and we've seen photos of her on set. And I think that's an interesting direction to go in, especially now that we have Stranger Things in the pop culture stratosphere, because everyone loves 11, and wouldn't that be an amazing team up? That's basically like baby Jean Grey and, Wolverine, female Wolverine. But it's an interesting choice with this poster. Then the other thing, we'll talk about the poster overall in just a second, my thoughts on it. But then you can see, I think a really important thing here is that he has scars on his hand. He's still healing. You can see not just where his claws have popped out, but you can see a cut on the upper wrist and on the hand. And that shows a compromised healing factor. Now, is that just due to age? Is that a run-in with maybe with Sinister, who was teased at the end of X-Men Apocalypse? Because this does take place far in the future. Although Sinister is basically immortal, so he could be in the 80s timeline of X-Men Apocalypse and show up, the Essex Corporation, and then show up in this future world. It could also be maybe a really badass villain that he's just thrown down with, and the cuts are a little deeper than he's used to. But speaking of a healing factor, I hope that the movie's healing factor is strong, because it's going to get so many strong, punches against it that month. So this comes out March 3rd. The very next weekend is Kong Skull Island. Then the weekend after that is Beauty and the Beast live action. Then after that, Power Rangers. And then after that, Ghost in the Shell. So like, wow, Wolverine, talk about having to fight multiple bad guys at once, or multiple villains. So as for the poster overall, kind of like the title Logan, I'm not really like, yeah, you know, like when I see it, I'm not like, this is gonna be amazing. You know, it goes more for touchy-feely than stabby-stabby, a term I use for Deadpool as well. And it's interesting because we'll talk about Deadpool when we look at things that we already know about the movie. But I just, you know, I think that people were really happy. A lot of fans were happy with how authentic that film was to the character. And I think that that's kind of what Hugh Jackman has been promising here. But yeah, I mean, although Wolverine is a big softy, right? He particularly likes to take, well, this sounds horrible, but he means it in a good way, young women under his wing and kind of be like a father figure to them, from Shadowcat, Kitty Pryde, to Jubilee, to here, X-23. And this is a good way to address that. They even did that with Rogue in the very first X-Men movie, although they really hurt that character, so nobody likes that who's an X-Men fan. But this is much more in the touchy-feely direction than the stabby-stabby one. I mean, obviously, it would be great if the movie could have a balance. But this actually reminds me a little bit of Copland, the movie that made this director, James Mangold, famous in the first place. You know, Sylvester Stallone being all touchy-feely, although Sylvester Stallone just watched Rocky. Rocky's a good balance. Copland, not so much. So I hope this movie can get the blood going. Now let's just quickly recap on what we already knew about the film. It is the last Hugh Jackman Wolverine movie. He said one last time. He's feeling sentimental about it. He recently shared a cover he commissioned from Joe Quesada, not only a comic book artist, but the head of Marvel Comics, the editor-in-chief, that he had commissioned as a gift for Bryan Singer. And you know, people have a lot of mixed feelings about Bryan Singer these days, but you know, Hugh Jackman, I think, understands that he owes his career to Bryan Singer deciding to cast him when his Bryan Singer's first choice and the studio's first choice wasn't available, because I don't even remember that guy's, it was like Doug something, I don't remember his name anymore, because he was stuck in Mission Impossible 2, you know, that production had run over. But so that was a nice thing to do. And he said, I think he really wants to go out getting a Wolverine movie right. And I think it's unlikely, as long as James Mangold is directing, to be perfectly honest with you. I think his visuals are not particularly good. Like, I don't know if he's going to be able to do a great fight sequence. I've never seen James Mangold direct a great fight sequence. I really like 310 to Yuma that he did, and I thought Night and Day was fun, but I don't think that he's a good match with the material, and I would have gone with someone else. You know, they tried to with Darren Aronofsky, but he dropped out of it. But I don't think James Mangold was a good replacement. The other thing we know about this, we've known about this film, is that it will be rated R. That's where the question about fight sequence comes in. Can James Mangold deliver, even though, you know, the restrictions have been removed? And again, they're trying to build on the success of Deadpool with that R rating. But, you know, it's the R rating itself isn't what everybody loved. It's what the R rating allowed. Then the other thing that we've known, of course, is that Patrick Stewart's Professor X will be in this film. It's also, I think, probably his last time as the character. Now, Professor X wasn't in the Old Man Logan storyline, but Emma Frost was, and actually had a pretty pivotal role. So perhaps that's why they decided to add Patrick Stewart's Professor X. It's also worth noting, I think, that while Stryker really hurt, James Logan. Hurt his path, took him off his life path. Patrick Stewart's Professor X is very much the one who's been a touchstone for Wolverine and put him back on. So to see that story come full circle, I mean, you always see them reconnect in the X-Men movies. So I think to really play that up could be very compelling. So it'll be interesting. Speaking of Weapon X, by the way, in the original comics, X-23 is created by a company trying to replicate Weapon X. And so we'll see if that's what they go with or Sinister. But look for that trailer soon. That's what we know so far. It's developing very quickly. And stay tuned for more coverage as it does develop. All right, I look forward to continuing the conversation down below. And you can check out some more videos right now.